Let's now return to what is arguably a very positive development in the fight against HIV/AIDS. Officials at the Joint Clinical Research Center say they are rolling out trials for injectable antiretroviral drugs. Until now, drugs for treatment of HIV and AIDS have been only in tablet form. But officials led by Cissy Chitio are optimistic that once approved, injectable ARVs will solve issues of non-adherence to treatment among people living with HIV/AIDS.
During a press conference held at the Joint Clinical Research Center in Lobowa, Kampala, it was revealed that Uganda has continued to make progress in the treatment and management of HIV/AIDS. New research has shown that HIV patients can also receive their antiretroviral treatment through injections instead of taking ARV tablets on a daily basis. Dr. Cissy Chitio Mutuluza, the head of the Joint Clinical Research Center, explained the drug trials.
For each of the drugs, and we give it on the bottle. And of course, the main side effect, which is going to be frequent, is an injection. It's pain. When you give an injection, it will be pain. But we also keep the patients for 30 minutes so that we observe them and just to make sure that they are not getting any side effects.
The injectable ARVs have already been rolled out in a number of developed countries. A number of tests are still underway.
Primary endpoints, viral load suppression with these long-acting ART. The second is safety. Are these drugs safe in our populations? Two key endpoints. These things are context. I can't tick pregnancy. And if the drugs are not doing well in pregnancy, we will still report, you know, these drugs are good, viral load, safety, but in pregnancy, maybe we shouldn't give them in pregnancy. Yeah, these are context things. Two endpoints, main ones.
And once you achieve that, you're good.
We are good, yeah.
That's what I wanted.
According to research, more women are infected with HIV compared to their male counterparts. At least 500 people are set to participate in these clinical trials for the next 2 years.
We are monitoring even less than 3 months all the participants on the study because they have the resources. In a public health context, the guidelines ask us, because of limited resources, we monitor our patients once a year with a viral load. Okay? For children, we do every 6 months. In this study, we will be monitoring viral load every 6 months. So then we will see, are we still seeing effectiveness, like control of viral load, if we are not taking, you know, the viral loads too frequently. There is another one. There is background resistance in our population. That's why we have changed to a new regimen now. That background resistance can, that resistance can come up again. So at baseline, we are going to take samples and measure that, what we call it acquired resistance. And we see if it has an effect on people who are failing.
In Uganda, over 1.5 million people are living with HIV and are on ARV treatment. However, there are still issues of drug adherence. The injectable ARVs, once approved, will solve issues of non-adherence since they are administered once every 2 months. Report by Julius Kafuluma for the news in Kampala.